there's two different ways to race in your home. You can play race, or you can simulate racing. And I firmly believe that if you're going to simulate racing, the best way to do that is to have a sim cockpit. Now, the R-Seat Evo V2 is one of those. It currently retails for $499 US. The options include a choice of black or white frame color, as well as black, white, or red seat color. Now, the R-Seat is unique in its construction as it has a single tube center frame that the seat, pedals, and wheel are all mounted to. The unique part of this arrangement is that the wheel is mounted using a U framework that swings around you rather than being mounted between your legs like the more typical center post rigs. The frame is made from a combination of welded and bolted together carbon steel tubing. The cockpit all comes very well packaged and is the most ready-to-race rig we've seen so far. In fact, you'll spend more time adjusting the cockpit to fit you than you will actually assembling it. And that brings up some of the best features of the R-Seat. It's fully adjustable. The seat has several options for adjusting its rake. Then the seat slides forward and back on the spine, as does the steering wheel mount and the pedal plate. So getting the perfect fit for your reach to the wheel and to the pedals couldn't be easier. Then, to make things even better, the pedal plate is adjustable for rake and even includes an adjustable heel plate. The steering wheel plate has adjustments for both height and rake. The seat is very race-oriented. It's a fiberglass shell with synthetic leather covering, and the seat wraps around you to hold you in place during those serious G-force corners. Now, the rig comes with a mount for the butt kicker, shifter brackets for the Logitech and Fanatec shifters, and both the steering wheel plate and pedal plates are pre-drilled for all the popular setups. The only thing we found missing is the keyboard tray for online PC racers. So, how's it measure up? Well, the almost infinite adjustability really sets this rig apart, as does its small footprint and lightweight. The lightweight means it's easier to move around and less expensive to get shipped, which on some rigs can add a lot to the final cost. And the seat really feels like a racing seat, not a car seat. And unlike many cockpits, this one adjusts small enough for smaller racers and those of us that like to sit tight and close in the cockpit rather than laid back. The bad? The seat bottom cushion definitely needs more foam, or at least a more dense foam, as your bottom can get a bit numb in like an hour's time. And while the shifter is adjustable, we wish it was able to extend up and forward just a bit more. The bottom line, an incredibly well-designed and constructed rig with ultimate adjustability and full race feel, might just be as good as cockpits get. The R-Seat is one of the best rigs we've ever tested, and you can count on a long-term report soon, as I'm going to put a lot of miles on this real quickly. For more information on the R-Seat, go to the R-Seat website at www.rseat.net, or in the USA, go directly to www.rseatusa.com.